The operating principle behind all filament extruders is the use of a drive wheel, otherwise known as a pinch wheel, which is held against the filament. Torque is applied to the drive wheel, which then forces the filament into the hot end for extrusion. Various methods are used to hold the filament against the drive wheel, the simplest of which is to just use a fixed plunger or set screw arrangement. The plunger provides force against the filament, which is then resisted by the drive wheel, causing the pinch effect. Note that in this configuration, the drive wheel is fixed in space and doesn't move. Some extruders, such as the Wade's, take this concept a step further. The filament and drive wheel are the same as before, but springs are used to provide the filament force. Typically, a spring-loaded bearing is used, which is allowed to move to adjust the gap which remains for the filament, hence allowing compensation for filament size. As before, the drive wheel turns, which forces the material into the hot end. I thought, there has to be a better way. What if the drive wheel not only applied the torque, but also was the driver for the force holding itself against the filament? To achieve this, the drive wheel had to be allowed to move. In this case, a bearing or plunger could still be used to provide the reaction force. If I could achieve this, the bearing or plunger which provides the reaction force could be fixed and doesn't have to move. This concept fascinated me, as it meant that the bearing itself was redundant. By mirroring about the filament, dual drive wheels could be used on a single filament, each providing the filament force as well as compensating for filament size. This unlocked the holy grail of extruders, the dual pinch wheel extruder. To implement this mechanism, I used a worm gear mounted to a stepper motor, with the mating worm wheel mounted to a shaft with an integrated drive wheel. This combination meant that the drive wheel could move along the length of the worm gear without compromising the gear meshing. Torque is applied by the motor, which is then transmitted to the drive shaft. Due to the operating principle of worm gears, there's also a tangential force generated by the mesh, which is usually a nuisance force for designers. The Kraken, however, utilizes this force to provide the filament force holding the drive shaft against the filament. As you can see, this fulfills all of the forces and movements required for the concept sketch above. To implement a dual pinch wheel extruder, two motors are used, with a worm gear pair on either side of the filament. Each motor and worm gear combination works exactly as described before. There is one particular benefit to this mechanism arrangement. Consider the filament force F versus the speed or torque applied by the motors. On a traditional extruder, F is constant regardless of speed or torque, although it can be adjusted up or down as a whole by adjusting the plungers or springs. On the Kraken, however, the filament force increases as the speed goes up or extra torque is required. This is because the tangential force generated by the worm gear pair is a function of the torque applied. Hence, filament force is only applied when it is required, and hence filament damage due to extrusion is minimized. This is what enables the Kraken to have such a wide operating condition for extrusion, and this principle applies regardless of whether a single or dual drive wheel is used.